Good morning, class. This is Aman Nirala, Assistant Professor, Department of Architecture and Planning, Jagannath University. And today's lecture is on the history of architecture, and the lecture topic is the Indus Valley civilization, and we can say in other words, Saraswati Sindhu Sabhyata. And in the class, we will learn about the early civilization of the Indus Valley extension and the mature civilization of Indus and Saraswati Valley civilization and the later extension of the settlements. The time period of Saraswati Indus civilization is considered and estimated from 6000 BCE to 1900 BCE. Between these time periods, the civilization undergoes several changes, starting the very early civilization which was discovered at Rakhi Gadi, Haryana in Hisar. The archaeological carbon age rating here is discovered as 6000 to 7000 years old, quite earlier than the recently discovered site of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, which our British archaeologists discovered during 1900s. Till before the discovery of the archaeological sites at Rakhi Gadi, this was only considered like Indus Valley civilization, because the two major cities of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro was established near the bank of river Indus. But later on, when the archaeologists and other artifacts help out in the discovery of Rakhi Gadi, there was a mummy found on the Rakhi Gadi in Hisar, Haryana, and that mummy of a woman, it was 7000 years old, carbon age estimated. So basically, this is the Gandhar mountains. This region was said to be Gandhar. And this mountain range is said as Hindu Kush. South of the Hindu Kush has a very fertile land and the river valley. And we have five major rivers flowing in from the Punjab. That is Ravi, Satluj, Jhelum, Chenab and Bias. And the major tributary rivers were adjacent to the Indus Valley, Indus River. So the civilization started near the bank of Saraswati and Indus. And there were two main port cities in the modern day Gujarat, we can say. Earlier, this is Lothal, and another one is Dholavira. These were two major port cities in the early and the mature in this river civilization, where the ships and the trading industries used to properly work upon. And we have seals and coins discovered at the site of Lothal and Dholavira. And this indicates that we had trade relations from this Indus settlements to the traders of Arabs. The major point of consideration in the Indus Valley civilization is the settlement and the city planning of Mohenjo-daro and Harappa. It was a total urban civilization and established around 4300 years ago. They first invented clay bricks, the clay bricks modules, and the first modern and the urban construction started in the time of Indus Valley civilization. When we will look at the sectoral planning and the city planning of Mohenjo-daro, we will find that there are roads which intersect each other at right angles, and these are the main roads you can see here, and the houses and the settlements are along these small roads, which is again connected to the main road. So you will find civilization establishments and the housing on the great iron pattern here. And they also developed a proper drainage system for the proper dispatch of the wastewater generating in the city. And so they had a very good calculation, the people from Indus Valley civilization, they had a very good calculation in trigonometry. And architecture. They had a very idea of the slope and how the wastewater can be, you know, drained out from the city. And so they have developed drains along with the housing settlements, along with the roads. And those drains were covered, not like the drains of today's. Those drains were completely made out of bricks and bitumen. And there is one more important archaeological site discovered at Mohenjo-daro is Great Bath. One is one of the most important point of consideration, that Great Bath. Great Bath is a common gathering place where the people from the various communities, they used to gather two times a day to take bath, and that was a common place for the public gathering. And this Great Bath was having a depth of 2.7 meters. When we will look at the section, this is 2.7 meters deep and 11 meters in length. A proper geometrical and rectangular plan you can observe. 11 meter, 7 meters, and the level is minus 2.7 meters. And this entire structure of Great Bath was built in the clay brick, baked clay brick. And the phenomenal waterproofing was done with the layer of bitumen and lime. So it is quite similar to a modern day swimming pool with a proper drainage system and water circulation system. The water here is collected from the pure sources and the used water is flushed out. So the entire system of the drainage was maintained with the drainage.